In this video, I will import a peak table coming from an automated sequencer. In my example database, I press the import button in the toolbar and select import peak table under fingerprint type data. In the first step, I need to browse for the peak file. When checking the option Import as Fingerprint File, curr files will be created using the height, size and area information that is present in the selected peak file. When this option is not checked, the peaks will directly be imported in the database without creating any curves. In this example, I will check the option and specify a name. The way the information should be imported in the database needs to be specified with an import template. In my example Beckman peak file, the dye, sample and pool information is provided. I can select the predefined template Beckman with pools. From the preview I can see that all information, including the pool and key information, is correctly parsed from the peak table file. I can use this template for the import of my peak file data, but I will demonstrate how to create your own customized template in case information in your files does not fit any of the predefined templates. I press the Create New button, and in the next dialog, all columns found in the peak file are displayed as rows in the grid. Since the first column contains the sample names, I will link this information to the key field. If I now press the preview button, I can check the rule that I have defined so far. From the preview, I can see that not a complete file name should be linked to the key field, but only the part that appears before the first underscore. I check the option Show Advanced Options. I make sure the first rule is selected, and I press the Edit Parsing button. This parsing string will omit all text appearing after the underscore. The correct part is linked to the key field. Next, I select the dye column in my peak file and link this information to the dye destination. Finally, I need to link the last four columns in my peak file to the correct BioNumerics peak fields. I link the first one to the marker field. The second one to the size field. Area column to the area field, and the last column to the height field. Because the first column in my peak file does not only contain information about the samples but also about the pools, I will add a new rule to the template. I press the Add Rule option. I choose the first column in my peak file as source and the pool information as destination. In the last step, I need to specify a parsing string. With this parsing string, the text appearing before the first underscore is omitted. The correct part is kept as pool information. When I press the preview button again, I can check all rules that I have defined so far. From the preview, I can see that all information is correctly parsed from the peak table file. I will import all dice in my database. And in the last step, I need to specify a template name. My template is now added to the database. I make sure my template is selected and press Next. A new base fingerprint type experiment will now be created. I specify a name and confirm the creation of the missing experiment in my database. In the next dialog, a few experiment settings for my new fingerprint type experiment need to be defined. The minimum and maximum fragment lengths, the resolution and the dynamic range, which is 16 bits in my dataset. For each imported die and pool combination, a fingerprint type needs to be present in the database. The name of these fingerprint types is composed of the base fingerprint type name, followed by the pool name and the name of the die. Since these fingerprints are not yet present in my database, I confirm the creation of the missing fingerprints. The new fingerprint types are added to the experiment types panel. A linear reference system between the maximum and minimum fragment length positions is created for each fingerprint type experiment. The import routine checks if the keys are already present in the database, and if not, new entries will be created. A fingerprint file is created per imported die. The individual lanes are assigned to their appropriate fingerprint type and linked to the corresponding entries. In the main window, we can see that all entries now have experimental data for all newly created fingerprint type experiments.